Assalamu alaikum.
Many other Americans have Muslims in their families or have lived in a Muslim majority country. I know because I am one of them.
But my father came from a Kenyan family that includes generations of Muslims. As a boy, I spent several years in Indonesia and heard the call of the azan at the break of dawn. I have known Islam on three continents before coming to the region where it was first revealed. That experience guides my conviction.
You're absolutely right that John McCain has not talked about my Muslim faith.
As the Holy Quran tells us, the Holy Quran teaches that, the Holy Quran tells us, and the Holy Quran also says,
we will convey our deep appreciation for the Islamic faith, which has done so much over the centuries to shape the world.
I would like to speak directly to the people and leaders of the Islamic Republic of Iran, your great and celebrated culture. Over many centuries, your art, your music, literature, and innovation have made the world a better and more beautiful place. We know that you are a great civilization, and your accomplishments have earned the respect of the United States and the world.
I also know civilization's debt to Islam. It was Islam at places like Uluzar that carried the light of learning through so many centuries, paving the way for Europe's Renaissance and enlightenment. It was innovation in Muslim communities that developed the order of algebra, our magnetic compass and tools of navigation, our mastery of pens and printing, our understanding of how disease spreads and how it can be healed. Islamic culture has given us majestic arches and soaring spires, timeless poetry and cherished music, elegant calligraphy, and places of peaceful contemplation. They have fought in our wars, they have served in our government, they have stood for civil rights, they have started businesses, they have taught at our universities, they've excelled in our sports arenas, they've won Nobel Prizes, built our tallest building, and lit the Olympic torch. And when the first Muslim American was recently elected to Congress, he took the oath to defend our Constitution using the same Holy Quran. In ancient times and in our times, Muslim communities have been at the forefront of innovation and education. Islam is not part of the problem in combating violent extremism. It is an important part of promoting peace. The enduring faith of over a billion people is so much bigger than the narrow hatred of a few. In the United States, rules on charitable giving have made it harder for Muslims to fulfill their religious obligation. That's why I'm committed to working with American Muslims to ensure that they can fulfill zakat. It is important for Western countries to avoid impeding Muslim citizens from practicing religion as they see fit. And I consider it part of my responsibility as President of the United States to fight against negative stereotypes of Islam wherever they appear.
We are no longer a Christian nation.
We do not consider ourselves a Christian nation.
The United States has been enriched by Muslim Americans.
Since our founding, American Muslims have enriched the United States. Islam has always been a part of America's story. There is a mosque in every state in our union, and over 1,200 mosques within our borders.
You know, one of the points I want to make is that if you actually took the number of Muslims, Americans, we'd be one of the largest Muslim countries in the world.
Let there be no doubt, Islam is a part of America.
he did bow to the Muslim king, while he did not do it to the British Queen of England. And by bowing, he showed the world that I am subservient. I do bow down to you as a Muslim king, something no other president has done with Saudi Arabia. The Saudi king is his peer. He is not his subordinate in order to bow for him. And this is exactly what Obama did. Usually it is out of respect that someone would nod his head when bowing to royalty and the ladies will give curtsy. But Obama went beyond what is required as a head of state and bowed to the Saudi king, and that's unacceptable. All right, why, it sent the wrong symbol.
What, when you say it sends the wrong signal, what signal do you think it sends?
It sent a message that Islam is superior to any other master or king or president in the world. That an American president bound to a Muslim king. It also sent a message that terrorism and jihadism is giving Islam the respect it should have on the world stage, to the point that it made an American president for the first time in history bow to a Muslim king.
Presidential candidate Barack Obama is trying to change political fashion. He gave a speech in Iowa City today, and he wasn't wearing an American flag pin. Those pins have become synonymous with politicians since 9/11. Obama says he doesn't like how the pin has come to represent patriotism in America.
I won't wear that pin on my chest.
It's a little weird, Alan, that in the middle of the campaign, the guy takes off the American flag that most people wear because they're proud of their country.
Let me speak as clearly and as plainly as I can. America is not and never will be at war with Islam.
Thank you. And Eid Shoma Mubarak.